For me, playing in the World Cup in France is a dream come true. Being able to play in the competition in your home country is extraordinary. It doesn't happen very often.
The waiting is nearly over for an expectant nation, and even the most experienced players are desperate for kickoff. Elise Bousaglia has made 188 appearances for France, but this is different.
For the French team, the aim is to win. We want to leave a mark on history. We haven't won anything yet, but we want to get all the way to the final and win the trophy. At the same time, I just want to explode and play.
But with home advantage comes added pressure. The enthusiasm of French supporters, even at training sessions, has reached new heights. The support across the nation is another big incentive for the players. The squad even met President Emmanuel Macron earlier this week.
It was a very patriotic message, very sincere. It was a really nice moment, but at the same time, it was very humble. It was a really informal meeting.
Over the next month, the aim of the squad is simple. Can they repeat the victory of the men's team last year and lift the Women's World Cup? The team hoping to puncture French optimism, a career republic. 9 years ago, they were under-17 world champions and semi-finalists at under-20 level. Will that now translate to senior football?
People call us the golden generation, but we know we have a long way to go. Playing against France won't be easy at all, but we've prepared well and we're ready for a good game.
The Koreans arrived in France ranked 14th in the world, 10 places below their hosts. And they were beaten 3-0 by the French when the teams met 4 years ago. Now they'll share the opening spotlight at the 2019 FIFA World Cup as France showcases the best of women's football.
I wasn't aware that there was a Women's World Cup when I was younger. And I grew up watching the Men's World Cup tournaments. But times have changed now. Nowadays, youngsters can watch women play. And they can dream.